I wanted to walk you through a way that we have acquired new clients in the past. This is stuff that I've really done. Like, I'm not theoretically saying that this might work. I can tell you that I have gotten clients this way. It's a multi-part step piece of it, requires a little bit of research. So as most of you know, the largest city near me where I'm at is Atlanta, Georgia. So I'm intentionally going to choose another city that is not near me so that I don't have any of the previous knowledge of any clients or anything like that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to choose San Antonio, Texas, because it's not near me. So I want suburbs of San Antonio. And I can just say that right there, Terrell Hills, we'll take that, right? I'm going to target accountants with this. And in order to do that, I am going to look up, I'm going to look up pastry shops. And you're like, wait, what? But hear me out. Watch this. So we're going to do Terrell Hills pastry shops, right? And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on more places. This is not something that's going to land you a client by the end of the day, but it is something that will land you clients on an ongoing and reliable basis. What I'm doing here is I'm looking for all these locations about how many reviews they have. This one's got an absolute ton. So does this one. 133, that's significantly less than what we've seen so far. 13, getting much better, but they're temporarily closed because we got the COVID thing going on. Walmart Bakery, we're not going to do Walmart. 1,200, holy cow, all right. 2, bingo. There, that right there is my first prospect. So here's what I would do with Meemaw Daw's sweet shop. I would go to Meemaw Daw. And I would have a screenshot of 893, 820, 133, 436, 598, and then they've got 2, right? And so what I would do is I would talk to Meemaw Daw, and I would probably find 5 or 6 different options. This one looks like a good one, but that's a cake shop, so it might be a little bit different. But I would find something like this. And here's what I'm going for. Pastries are cheap, right? Like donuts, the little scone things or bagels or whatever, like breakfast foods, they're cheap. It's very easy for you to go buy several dozen of them. And so we're going to come back to that in a second. Cupcakes, stuff like that. All this stuff down here, it's relatively cheap. So what I'm looking for is somebody with a low review count that's in an industry that has high review counts. And I'm going to offer to do their Google reviews, their ratings and review management for free. You get into the certified partner program, you'll see all the trainings on how we prospect it and pitch it. But I would target them, go talk to the owner and say, listen, I'm looking for a local partner that needs my help because I need your help. And I would say, I'm going to do this for free. I would, you know, really drive up. I mean, if they got 2 reviews, we could easily start dominating that within, you know, a week. And so they're going to be really happy with us really quickly. Here's what I would do in return, or what I would expect in return. I would talk to Meemaw Daw and tell her that I would like to be able to buy all of your food, all these pastry items, at cost. In other words, I'm going to do this for you for free, but I would like to be able to come in here and buy at cost. I understand I'm still going to have to pay, but I'm covering their cost, so they're not losing money on it. But I don't want to pay full retail, right? So that should cut the price down by like 40-50%. You picked 3 or 4 of these pastry shops, I would say 50 to 75% of them are on board with that, right? If they really need the help and they see the value. Now, if Meemaw Daw is 82 years old and has no idea what Google reviews are, she's probably not a good fit. But you'll find one that's on board with this idea and realizes that they need help with it, right? So never mind the fact that you'll probably get a client because they'll need web design services, they'll need social media. You'll probably get a client with the pastry shop, but that's not even what we're going for. What I'm going to do is I'm going to head over to Canva or Photoshop, depending on your skills. If you don't have any creative skills, like I'm not the most creative person in the world, I would probably go to like Upwork or Fiverr and just get somebody to design a little business card. The business card or small little flyer would say something to the effect of, like a little postcard that says, I chose Meemaw Daw's Sweet Shop because of their awesome online ratings and reviews. What do your online ratings and reviews say about your company? Okay. And again, I said we're going to target an accountant, right? Accountants generally have pretty low ratings and reviews. Yeah, none, 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 2, none, 2, None, none. Like, okay, so none of them have any, right? This is extremely low-hanging fruit. What if you were to target any of these? And by the way, the thing I love about accountants and attorneys, especially accountants, because attorneys are pretty saturated, but they always put their name on it. Like, I know that I'm trying to get in touch with Theodore Meyer. I know that I'm trying to talk to Robert Torres, right? Like, I know that Diana Martinez is the person that I'm trying to talk to. Like, they normally put their name on the business. It's just extremely easy to find who the decision maker is. Well, here's the way I would go about this, right? And this will work for dentists, chiropractors. It'll work for anything. I'm just using the example with an accountant. So I would then take my box of pastries that I bought at cost, right? So you're out, what, $4 or $5 for a box of bagels, whatever. I'm going to go take them and I'm going to drop them off at these target places. I might buy 5 boxes of them and go to 5 places. And what I'm going to do is just leave it. And I'm just going to have my business card and that little postcard on the inside of the box says, what does your company's online reputation say about you? I might even find one that had a negative review mixed in if I could. And look at this, more than 10 pages of results. So there's just a ton of opportunities here. So what I would do with that is on the postcard, I would go to qrcodegenerator.com and I just threw together a landing page that includes a couple of key pieces, right? So, I might even make this more specific about accountants. Like this tagline might say, would you trust an accountant that had bad online ratings and reviews? No. So I made a quick little video about a client that already uses Five Star Ninja. They're blowing it out of the water with their ratings and reviews. We started this process with them and they had I think they had 1 or 2, maybe it was 1. And then now, like, this is an old picture. They're up past 77 now. So, and then we've got the testimonial video and we've got their real Google business listing. So you can go on there and you can see that we're not, you know, Photoshopping this. This is not made up. They really do have 82 ratings and reviews. So what I would do is I would make this page like, so what does your reputation say about your company? It might be, would you trust an accountant with your money that didn't have good online ratings and reviews, right? But the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to copy this URL on the page that's on my website. I'm going to go over to QR code generator. These things are free and there's dozens of them. And I'm going to enter my URL, right? So now this right here, I can download this JPEG and this is my, let's see if we can't grab just the image itself. So there's my QR code that I can put on my little flyer. And when I put that on my flyer and somebody scans it, you would probably also put the URL to it so that if they typed it on a computer. But if they scan that with their cell phone, you know, you put a little thing underneath that says scan me. Now they're looking at a page that talks about how important online ratings and reviews are and you happen to offer that service. Well, you think you're going to get a call back? I mean, yeah. So you've got positive ratings and reviews from people directly in their industry that are not in their local area. So like this person's in South Georgia versus, you know, San Antonio, Texas in this example. So they're not intimidated by the positive reviews, but it's somebody that's pertinent to their industry. You're able to go in there with a service that is relatively cheap. I mean, for you to say all of your competition has, you know, less than 5 reviews, and I'd go find some examples where people have like 10 and say, well, what if I brought you 70? What if I got you 70 online ratings and reviews? Do you think that would help your phone ring? Well, you don't have to wonder because we've got an entire client study over here that talks about how much their phone rang. We've even got, this is literally a screenshot. I had nothing to do with this. There's a screenshot from this account. And the guy even mentions in the review that the reason he tried them is because of their positive reviews. I mean, they even got new employees because of how good their online ratings and reviews are compared to everybody else around them. So, yeah, you're going to make their phone ring a lot more. Like if this Theodore Meyer right here, right? If they went from 0 ratings and reviews to 40, and by the way, how many clients do you think they have? We just got out of tax season. So you think they've got a bunch of clients that they just did their taxes for them? Yeah, absolutely. So it's low-hanging fruit to be able to drive these ratings and reviews up. Now, if I were to go to, let's just take one as an example. This one's fine, Mateo. If I go look at his website and I start digging in through the online presence audit, I see immediately doesn't have a Facebook pixel. I could go through and check his Google tags and all that. There's going to be additional services that you're going to be able to help them with, but you're leading with something that if I go charge them $150 a month to do their ratings and reviews, and over the next 3 to 4 months, I take him from what do you have, two? If he had any, might not have had any, but if I take him from 2 to 40, do you think he's going to be happy with me? Yeah, absolutely. So it's just a great way to get in the door with a client that's going to open up additional service for you. And you saw how quickly we threw this together. I mean, this page took me maybe 5 minutes. Granted, I didn't really type out the content, but you could type out, you know, some of the things that are about you. Do a video with your cell phone. Obviously do it in landscape mode so it takes up the full video, but do a video with your cell phone. This one was actually filmed with a cell phone. So you can do a video with your cell phone that just says, hey, my name is John Doe. I work with XYZ agency in your area. We specialize in getting people good online ratings and reviews. We specialize in review management because we know that's what helps get you selected by people looking for your services in your area. Give us a shout and let's show you how we could increase your online ratings and reviews with real clients and real positive ratings that are going to help you get selected. Give me a call at 1-234-567-8910 or email me at john.doe@exampleagency.com. Whatever you want to do your video on, throw your videos in here. I've even got a chat bot so that when this thing loads up, this may be overkill. You may not want to do it, but this thing, you know, I could hook this up to where it's automatically trying to schedule them a call or an appointment, so that you could walk through exactly, you know, what you're trying to get them on board for. So anyway, this is just a strategy that we've literally used. We use it to get in the door to places where you've now got a partner that you can do this in multiple industries. So you got a pastry shop or pick whatever, you know, whatever food you want, just something that you can put on the desk and they'll call you back. And then, you know, get those printed up. You can get them printed at your local print shop. You can get them on VistaPrint for extremely cheap. Get 100 of them. And I mean, they're going to be pennies, you know, for each one. You'll spend $20 on it. You'll spend $5 on a box of bagels. And if you land one client, 1 month is going to pay for it. Not to mention that we use this service all the time just to get in the door, but it's extremely rare. In fact, I can't think of any clients that we have where that was the only service that we ended up offering them. We always end up with website redevelopment, with SEO, with local SEO, with social media management. Like, it always segues into other services. You have a certified partner program where you can offer these services with software that makes it just stupid easy for you. So anyway, this is a quick client acquisition video tutorial that we wanted to do. If you've got questions or comments, you know what to do with them. Put them in the free Facebook group and we will answer them as they come. Appreciate you watching and we will see you soon.